In the previous video, we saw how the one-time pet scheme can be used to send a secret message securely. There is nothing quantum about the one-time pet scheme. It only involves classical zeros and ones. In this video, we will use a quantum key distribution scheme to generate a secret key, which can then be used in the one-time pet scheme for sending a message securely. We will first give an overview of the possible single qubit states and measurements we will use. The second part of the video is devoted to explaining a famous quantum key distribution scheme called BB84, named after its inventors Charles Bennett and Gilles Brassard. In the BB84 protocol, we will use four different single qubit states. There's the zero state, here represented by an upward arrow, the one state, a downward arrow, and the plus and minus states, here depicted as horizontal arrows. On top of this, we will use two possible measurement bases, a vertical basis and a horizontal basis, in which you can think of as slits through which the state passes. We denote the two possible outcomes as red and blue. For those of you who have seen these states before, you probably recognize these as the four cardinal states in the XZ plane of the Bloch sphere. The two measurement bases are the Z bases on the left and the X bases on the right. Furthermore, the outcomes blue and red correspond to the outcomes +1 and -1, respectively. If these names do not sound familiar to you, then don't worry. We will not need them in the remainder of this video. Let us do a short recap of measuring single qubit states. Suppose we have a qubit, a yellow arrow, and a measurement basis, the round slits. And now we measure the qubit in the basis. Then if the state of the qubit aligns with the measurement basis, then only a single outcome is possible. Moreover, the state of the qubit does not change, and from the measurement outcome, we learn its state. This situation is depicted in the upper two examples. In the left one, we measure a horizontal state in a horizontal basis. The arrow passes through the slit unharmed, and the outcome is blue since the arrow points upward. A similar explanation can be given for the picture in the right upper corner. When the measurement basis and the qubit state do not align, the situation is very different. In the example in the left lower corner, the horizontal state is measured in a vertical measurement basis. The state then flips to vertical direction, either to up or to down, each with a probability of 50%. The measurement outcome is precisely related to the direction of the arrow after the flip, blue if the state flipped to up, and red if the state flipped to down. Analogously, measuring a vertical state in a horizontal basis also yields a completely random outcome, as can be seen in the lower right corner. Using a similar reasoning, one can find out if the outcome and post-measurement state are completely predictable or random for all eight possible combinations of states and measurement bases. Measuring a single qubit state could be summarized in the following lines. A single qubit should be measured in an aligned basis to ensure that we extract its original direction. And this alignment also influences the state after the measurement. Next, we will look at the BB84 protocol for generating a secure shared key. The protocol consists of two parts. In the first part, we use qubits for encoding classical information, and the second part is a post-processing step, which does not involve any quantum operations at all. The setup is as follows. There's Alice on the left and Bob on the right. And in real life, they are far away from each other, so they cannot see each other's actions. The BB84 protocol starts by Alice picking a random sequence of bits, which you have written here as R's and B's instead of zeros and ones. These are reds and blues. On top of this, she picks a different random sequence of directions, here depicted as vertical and horizontal instead of zeros and ones. In the third step, she encodes this information into single qubit states. In a fashion that is compatible with the measurement bases we saw before, she encodes the two sequences bitwise as arrows. For example, she turns blue plus horizontal in a right-pointing state, she turns red plus vertical in a down-pointing state, and so on and so forth for the remaining qubits in the random sequences. And these qubits, she then sends to Bob. Bob receives the qubit and draws a sequence of random measurement bases. Note that writing such bases as a direction, as we did here in green arrows on the left with Ellis, comes down to precisely the same thing as writing them as measurement bases here on the right with Bob. In the next step, Bob measures the qubits he received from Ellis bitwisely in a randomly chosen basis. Note that this looks surprisingly much like the reverse of what Ellis did when she was encoding the qubits. Also note that the outcomes that Bob has are identical to Ellis's initial randomly chosen bits in the case that her chosen direction is identical to Bob's chosen measurement basis. And if these two are different, then the outcomes are different with a probability of 50%. Now, if this went a bit too fast, then I encourage you to pause the video for a bit and convince yourself why the statement there in the orange block is indeed correct. The next part of the BB84 protocol does not involve any quantum anymore, but only consists of classical post-processing. First, both Ellis and Bob publicly announce their measurement bases. Everyone in the world may hear these, even people wishing to eavesdrop on Ellis and Bob's communication. After this, Ellis and Bob remove all R's and B's, where their measurement bases are different. The resulting R's and B's must necessarily be the same on both sides. It is important to realize that the measurement bases on both sides have been made public, but that the R's and B's are still secret. And this means that we can use the R's and B's as a secret shared key between Ellis and Bob. We finish this video with the last take-home message. With the BB84 quantum key distribution scheme, Ellis and Bob generate a shared secret key without having to communicate securely beforehand. And this key can then be used in a one-time PET scheme for sending a message securely. Yeah.